So today I'm going to talk a little about some fun food with vegan. I made the blue tortillas. Now you can get the Masa Harina in blue now. They take it out there and they put it on a sack and it's blue. And very simple. Two cups to one cup of warm, and then add a half a cup in later after it's all mixed, and then put it into little balls and then smash it. But when you smash it, you don't need the metal press. You can use a Pyrex, a flat Pyrex casserole dish or a square one, just push it down over sheets of plastic or wax paper, and you end up with almost like perfectly round tortillas. I did all of this all by my lonesome. Let me see, most of them are perfectly round. So anyway, here, tantria. And it's supposed to make like, I don't know, make 16 of them or so. But yeah, very neat. And they taste a little bit better than the store, I must admit. The store ones don't have that extra fun flavor. I don't know, the store ones are okay. I'm not gonna diss them completely. Okay, another idea I have, and I haven't seen this on the market, is prickly pear juice. Prickly pears are in season, and I just cut into this one. And if you notice up close, it has, see all those little nodules? Those are seeds, and they're tough, they're very tough seeds. So to eat this, it's actually very delicious. It's like a vanilla kiwi flavor. But to actually get through it, you have all the seeds to spit out. So I'm recommending it as a juice, okay? And these are in season, and they're kind of fun. So we have, here's like a one, it just showed up off a bush. And then that's it after, when you cut it. So anyways, I'm going to try the juices tomorrow, but I'm certain they're going to be delicious. So that's all I have in vegan world, fun and new food. Yeah, I have a feeling as a juiced item, because it's very liquidy, much like, gosh, I want to say, it's almost like an orange juice, actually. It's that juicy, but it's not. It's not as juicy as an orange. But very, very, very juicy fruit. Anyway, so you can imagine as an Indian on the plains, you're coming across this in the desert, you're like, whoa, I'm happy, even if I have to spit out your seeds, you know, because that's very quenching. Very quenching. And that's it. That's for my hit, my vlog hit. All right. I've just been painting and wall building lately. So yeah, painting. I'll maybe show pictures later. House doors. I'm painting the doors of the house. I'm on like the fourth, fifth coat. I like the character it's building, you know, it just builds out from the door. The door starts to lose its tracked cookie cutter look, because a lot of them have this wood grain cookie cutter look, and they're very staid compared to like a real old, like a Victorian style house, you know, a real old door that has some real depth to it. So I'm trying to bring that depth out with a lot of paints. Now I know you have to sand ever so often, but that's the way it goes. Anyway, prickly pear is having its day in the sun. And this one has got a little rot on the bottom, but it's still okay when you cut into them. They're still very edible on the inside. And the stores are nice, and they take the prickly pear, the actual prickers off now. They have some cleaning machine that gets rid of those, so you can hold them without getting the stickers. If you pick from the bush though, in the wild, yeah, definitely have gloves, really tough gloves, And you can try with paper bags. I've seen people collect them with paper bags, but I suggest real good garden gloves, tough ones. Okay. Yeah, and because those bushes, they produce, man. You just keep going and going. Okay, enough of my happy show.